Hello and welcome back to the channel. So in this video we're going to take a look at one of our brand new installations. We just completed a 7 kilowatt black tethered Zappi car charge installation. So let's jump into it, let's take a look. So this is actually the rear of the property. We've got the garage over there, which has a little mini consumer unit or a fuse box. And then up in that corner, that's where the customer got the electric meter cabinet. And then inside this extension bit, they got the main consumer unit for the whole house. So we had three options. We could either come off that board here, we could come off the meter cabinet, or we could come off the existing fuse box inside of the house. We had a look at all three of them. The garage fuse box is actually a lot smaller. It only has a little 2.5 mil cable coming into it, supplying power. So that's not good enough for what we need because we've got a 7 kilowatt car charger. Then we looked at the option of coming from the consumer unit. Again, it's a bit congested. It's inside a kitchen unit and we didn't really want to drill into kitchen units to get the cables in and out. So we decided to come off the electric meter cabinet, which is just there. And we clip the cable neatly along the bottom edge up here and then into the charger unit.
Thank you.
So let's take a look at the installation work inside the meter cabinet. Now we've got the main service head from the supplier that comes into the property. It goes through the electric meter and then into an isolator, which gives you an option to cut off the power to the entire installation within the house. So these tails go from here into the consumer unit, the fuse box, which is located sort of on the other side of this wall inside one of the kitchen units. So what we've done is that the tails are going out from the isolator switch. We've cut them tails and we fitted these 100 amp single pole terminal blocks, or some people call them Henley blocks, service blocks. And that gives us option to add, it gives us extra option to take out more tails into additional fuse boxes. So that's exactly what we've done. We then come off with double insulated 6mm tails, supplying power into a mini consumer unit or a mini double pole module box. Right, so we've got the CT clamp for the Zappi installed in here. That's another a good gadget that comes with the Zappi. We generally use the EV Ultra cable, which has the 6mm power supply as well as the data function built into it. But on this installation, we have actually used a separate Cat6 cable. So this actually feeds the consumption data back into the Zappi. So in your app, you'll be able to see how much power is being consumed by your car and your house and all of that. So so that's the setup. So this is a fairly common setup with a lot of the car chargers now. And Right, so let's take a quick look at the Zappi black tethered car charger. So in the previous video, we installed an untethered Zappi with a white frame. So this time we've got a black Zappi with a tethered, with a cable. Frame's black, everything else is pretty much the same. All the functionality is all the same. It's just that this got the cable and the black frame. So if you take a closer look, quite a simple dial at the front. We've got the menu access through this button here, and then the customer can change the charge settings through these little arrows. You've got three functions. You've got the fast charge, you've got the eco, and then you've got the eco plus charge. So currently this is charging at a full rate at the fast charging function. And got a nice little display here as well, which indicates how much power being drawn into the car, into the house, and also if you've got solar panels and things, this can easily talk to communicate between them and then just get the right readings. So currently obviously this property doesn't have any solar installations, so just indicating the how much power going into the house and then coming into the car. So simple as that. Nice little compact unit. I mean, some of the other chargers we installed, they are a lot smaller than this, but this got the option to, you know, sort of reel your cable around it. And lots of other customers go for Zappi chargers these days. It's just quite reliable. And this is the second generation Zappi. So you've got the Wi-Fi receiver unit built into it, whereas the version one or the previous generation had the separate Wi-Fi hub that we had to plug into the router. So they have made a few changes to the charger. So we can do just everything from the outside of the house, connect it all up, and we get it up and running. So with regards to the app, so there's a smart app that comes with the charger. You can download that into your mobile phone and then configure the app through your Wi-Fi. Once it's set up through the app, you can see all your charge history, how much your entire consumption for the car, and you can set like schedule timing. So there's lots of smart features built into that app, and the app communicates straight into the charge itself. So yeah, lots of tech built into it. Nice compact charger. So yeah, let's take a look at the rest of the installation. Right, so just the final commissioning left now. I'm going to use our Metrel MI3152 multifunctional tester with the EVSE testing equipment. So generally on an untethered version, I would normally plug that straight into the charger, but in this case, I'll have to plug it into the end of this cable. So let's get this connected first. Right, okay, so that's all connected now. Righty, let's get that plugged in there. Okay, let's turn this on. Test adapter plugged into the cable coming out of Zappi. Now in this test adapter we've got, this is the A1532XA. We've got the PP dial, which would allow you to set the amount of power that this is going to draw for the test. And then you've got three functions in here. So function A, it indicates that the EV is plugged in. The B indicates EV is plugged in but not charging. When you put that into C, then it would put the charger into the charging mode. So this got the facility to mimic the fact that you've got a car plugged into the charger and to carry out your complete test, which is quite handy because sometimes we install the charger but the customer doesn't have the car delivered for another 3 or 4 months. So for us to carry out the test, this is a good piece of kit. What we're going to do now is we are going to do a couple of tests onto the RCD built into the unit, as well as the loop impedance value test and the general commissioning test. So let's get to the charger unit. Right, so all our testing's been carried out. It passed all the tests, RCD, loop impedance, and all the functional tests, communication tests, everything's done. So I'm going to take this lead, plug it into the car, and then make sure the car's charging properly. So right, so let's go and do that. Just plugged it in to do a quick test. Obviously we've done all our tests with our testing equipment, but we always, if the car customer has the car delivered on site, then we normally plug it in and to do a quick final check. So that's plugged into the car. It's going to start communicating between the charger and the car, and then this will start to charge in a few seconds. So I can see in my charger the light's now gone from purple into white, and it's indicating it's charging. So the car's now fully starting to charge at 7.5 kilowatt, because currently it's on the fast charge settings. Customer do have the option to change that between Eco and Eco Plus, but yeah, we're going to leave that on fast charge so he can get the quick charge, because he's got to go somewhere in shortly. And that is it then. So that's another installation complete, and we'll see you in the next video. Thank you.